Randy's the one that really pursued getting the band together. And he showed up at my house with his drums in the back of his truck and finally talked us into it. We're more concerned about going out at night instead of getting in a band. And then went over to Randy's house and called Grady up. And he showed up the next night, and man, it just rolled from there. Seven nights a week, we practiced until our first gig. Man, it was instant, and we knew that we had something. We just knew it was gonna take a little time to get it right. We're still waiting. We never really pursued a label. We started getting phone calls. They were coming out to shows. Because, I mean, to us, it was all about this, still is, just about playing, you know, not about record sales and stuff. Make sure bands took it. But we started getting the phone calls that, you know, like Mercury was going to come out one night, Universal coming out one night, DreamWorks coming out another night. Then we knew about the third record label that hopped on board. We thought, yeah, this is going to happen. Universal signed us in Raleigh, North Carolina. They didn't sign us, but they offered it to us. Tim Dubois said, well, boys, I just offered you a record deal. So we went to the bar and got shit-faced.
Been doing it ever since.
We're still celebrating.
When I first heard us on the radio, I think I was in my car or something, driving somewhere, and I thought of somebody else doing our songs. I'm like, who's this? And it was us. Like, wow, we're on the radio now. Cool.
When we record albums or whatever, like, some of the songs that we do we'll have in the can for like a year. So we know exactly how we arrange it and just go in there and we'll knock it out real fast. But, like the last album we did, Garage, we had 4 songs and then that was it when we went in there. We basically came up with 10 other songs while we were in the studio. So we kind of done it both ways.
I couldn't imagine doing anything else but what we're doing on the road. And, you know, it is tough sometimes, family. Now that we all have kids now, that's the toughest part. But once you get on the road and start doing it, it's great.
One of the funniest times that I have playing was here in Tulsa. We're, you know, it's late. We've had a lot of drinks. We end the song and come down on the cymbal, last note, big finish. And I guess I reached too far and I fell off the drum seat, knocked over a guitar, and a bunch of drinks just started falling all over my head. The entire crowd just erupted and started laughing.
I was pretty much convinced that I would probably be a truck driver for a long time. But I started playing bass and guitar when I was about 10 or something, so it was always kind of in the back of my mind. You know, what if I could do this for a living? You know, what if I could
get so good, get a band, play all over the place?
You know, and it was always just kind of a novel idea in the back of my head.
Get loaded every night.
Get loaded every night.
And and now it's, I mean, now living a dream, I guess. It's I mean, really, that's really the only way to put it.
The coolest act recently that we opened for was on the road. And we were on one stage, they were on another, but you know, we still opened for them. You know, that was one of them.
That's probably the best live band I've ever seen.
I of course, love anywhere but here. And not just because of the solos, just everybody's intensity on that song whenever we do it live. It's always the same, but it's just way up there. I mean, everybody just throws it all out there on the table. Yeah. Just gets 1,000%.
And, that's impossible.
Not really.
We started off playing four-hour gigs. And then it started getting down to like, well, the contract is 90 minutes. And there were some places that would want you to play 90 minutes and get out. it's, man, we just, 90 minutes is almost like an opening act. No, we just love to play.